today we are going to film 1,000,000 frames per second.
Yeah, we were setting up the ring for some Prince Rupert's drop shots, and I shot one candy with the air rifle, and the footage is absolutely amazing. So I think we have to just dedicate one video about the 1,000,000 frames per second frame rate.
Yeah.
I think that's good enough for video. And I want to shoot a couple more things with the air rifle, and we might come up with also some other things to do. But first I show what it takes to film 1,000,000 frames per second. We are running quite short shutter time, so we have some lights.
Yeah, we're running 1 microsecond shutter, which requires every bit of light we can get. So we have 5 kilowatts of water-cooled LEDs mounted pretty much as close as we can dare. This table gets so hot you can't touch it.
We were already talking that we should have liquid-cooled table because it's so hot. Yeah, and I think we are going to just shoot one of these. I think I'm going to start with this. Mm-hmm. And this was for the calibration. That's also a bit tricky with this piece. But the one shot that we already did, it was Turkish pepper candy. When you know how hard it is to film like this, that was really good shot. I can put, for comparison, I can put one of our 300,000 frame shots next to that, and you can see the difference. Which would be your choice, this or that?
How good a shot do you think you are?
I think I'm pretty good. I would like to get the head off.
Okay. Let's go for this one.
Okay, he's going in. Yes, so here we go. And I really want to get the head off from the thing. So it's pretty small target. Let's see. I think I can make it. I think I missed.
Yeah.
I have to do it again. Yeah, I just touched it. Hey, I think I... It was shot to the heart.
Oh no!
I think this is going to still be really nice. The arm flew up also away. Yes, so the head didn't come off, but shot to the heart. And I made, or actually you made,
yeah,
these super nice double sunglasses. When the sun shines double as bright. Yes, so we are ready. Double sunglasses, extra light for the sides. It's really hard shot, but I think I can make it. I think I hit too low again, but let's see. We have plenty of those guys left. New target, and this time I aim higher. I think that was pretty good. Yes, and we found the head, and it's about maybe 2 millimeters to right from the center, but that's pretty cool still. And it's amazing that the head survived. we get the slow motion soon, but we had already picture of couple frames, and seems that the head continues much faster than the bullet after the hit, so it's going to be really great. Yes, and we are already getting ready for the next shot while the computer is computing. And this is going to be next one, so it's glass bottle full of booze. And we cannot see the whole bottle, but we are going to see about this much and full width of the bottle. So we should see some nice shattering thing. And I'm hoping that the bullet will go through. It's not sure because this is so thick glass, but we will see out soon. Yes, and we changed the booze to blue water to make it better on the camera. And this should be easy shot after the Lego guys. Really hard to see anything. I think it was pretty good shot. I tried to hit pretty low so it's on the frame. Yes, so the last shot, here it comes. But I think there is enough for 1 million frames per second stuff. It's quite slow and tricky to film that, so...
And quite slow and tricky to hit anything.
And if you want to learn more about the ring, there is link in description and on end screen for David's video about the ring. There is a bit more like technical data and how it works and what you can do with it. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.